بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم نحمده ونصلي على رسول الكريم أما بعد. The Quran is the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and one should make all effort to read the book to fulfill the haqq and the right of it. So just making tilawat of Quran for the sake of tilawat and reading as fast as we can and just making the khatam defeats the purpose. Yes, it is mubarak, it is blessed, but we should try to maximize. Somebody who feels I need to eat and consumption is a need, then just cook the rice and keep it like that. Eat plain white rice. The meat that you have, you don't need to put any spices. But when effort is made on the rice, on the meat, and it is flavored and it is barbecued, it enhances everything. So the Quran should be enhanced. Aisha radiallahu anha used to say, one day when she heard a person reading Quran very fast, said, "Inna hadha ma qara al Quran." He has not read any Quran. Abu Umama radiallahu anha used to say, "Iqra'u al Quran." Read the Quran and don't be deceived. Don't be deceived by the power of the Quran, because that person who fulfills the haqq of the Quran and protects the Quran, then punishment cannot come to that person. Ibn Abbas radiallahu anhu may say, "Lan aqra al-baqara," that I read Surah Baqarah and Al-Imran, "urrattilahuma wa atadabbaruhuma," and I ponder on these and I read slowly, "ahabba ilayya min an aqra al-Quran," more beloved than me making an entire khatam is to read short surahs, but to read them properly. So part of tilawat of Quran is to make intentions and to see how we can make, maximize and utilize this tilawat so that it is beneficial. They say dynamite comes in small packages. So it may be small, it may look insignificant, but when it's done properly, then its effect is greater. So the ikhlas and the niyat, why we read in Quran, there's different niyat and intentions, but we need to get this intention correctly. So in lughat, in the dictionary, it is called safa, purity. So like water is pure, then you will drink it. When the milk is pure, then you will enjoy it. So it should be unadulterated. Like how for dunya, we want purity. In the petrol tank, if the petrol is contaminated and it's with other ingredients, then we may seize the engine or cause serious problems. Likewise, for Allah, we need to make sure, وَمَا أُمِرُوا إِلَّا لِيَعْبُدُ اللَّهَ مُخْلِصِينَ لَهُ الدِّينَ, that for every amal, we do this properly. So where a servant in Shariat that sidqul abdi i'tiqadan wa amalan fi tawajjuhihi ila Allah, that a servant is sincere and truthful internally and externally, and his attention is totally to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That's why Mashaykh say that al-ikhlasu tasfiyatul amal min kulli shawbin, that it is purifying every amal from any form of contamination, any adulteration, to purify. So every amal that we do in our 24-hour day, we need to check ourselves and our sincerity. Some mashayikh say, al-mukhlis wal-ladhi la yubali, he does not concern himself what other people are saying or what other people are going to think of what he's doing. Some say, may yaktum hasanah tihi kama yaktum sayyati, that a person will hide his good deeds like how a person hides his evil. So like how you stay away from wrong and you don't want people to know your wrongs, you hide your good deeds as well. Others say, al-mukhlisu may yastawi indahu مَادِحُهُ وَذَامُهُ, that if somebody had to praise you or rebuke you, they both are equal. There's no difference. Sahal Tastari Rahimallah used to say that the most difficult thing on the nafs, the hardest thing on the nafs is ikhlas. The most difficult thing on the nafs is ikhlas. لِأَنَّهُ لَيْسَ لَهَا فِيهِ نَصِيب, because the nafs will not benefit. This is directly what Allah. So you'll do an amal, nobody will know about it, there'll be no name, there'll be no fame. Sufyan Thawri used to say, مَا عَلَّجْتُ شَيْئًا أَشَّدْ عَلَيَّ مِن نِيَّتِي, there's nothing more difficult on me that I had to make effort to reform and resolve except my intentions. إِنَّهَا تَتَقَلَّبُ عَلَيَّ, because this intention changes all the time. So the Kalam-e Pak as well, we need to check our intentions and see that we benefit. It's not just reading or just passing life or passing Mubarak days, blessed Ayyam. A person sees Ramadan, a person sees Jummah, they see the Eids, they see these Mubarak Ayyam, and it just passes by. That's not the object of life. It was a farmer who had a garden and he made effort many years to plant fruits. And when he perfected the formula and the time came for harvesting and he went into his field, he found a stranger sitting on a branch eating the fruits and pecking some for himself. So he became very angry. He said, what are you doing on the tree? Aren't you ashamed that you are stealing fruits? So the stranger looked at him and didn't say anything. And he continued eating. So the farmer became very upset. And he said, it's taken me so many years to perfect this formula and you are enjoying it without any permission. So the stranger said, why should I come down? This garden is the garden of Allah. I am the servant of Allah. This is the fruit of Allah. And this is because of the permission of Allah. So Allah has given me permission. That's why I'm eating it. If he didn't give me permission, I wouldn't have been here and I wouldn't have been eating it. So he was very shocked again. So he told his son, go bring a stick and some rope. And he tied the person up and he started beating him. So the person asked him, what are you doing? And he carried on beating him. He said, what are you doing? Okay, stop, tell me. So the farmer said that, do you understand? He said, no. He said, don't you fear Allah? You're beating an innocent person. He said, don't you know that his hands belong to Allah? I am the servant of Allah. And you should not interfere with the work of Allah. Allah has decided that you should be beaten. So he said, okay, maaf, I made a mistake. I've learned my lesson. So it should not be as well that we are saying that things are carrying on, we are doing things, we are trying, but we are not exhausting every avenue to make sure. It shouldn't be the stick of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala comes and a person has to take lesson then. So we need to reform our lives. Quran is for Hidayat. And the first niyyah that we're making is Niyyatul Hidayah. Ihdina siratal mustaqim. That in every rakat of every salah, we are asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for Hidayat. Because the most greatest ingredient is, most important ingredient for a person is Hidayat. According to the need is things revealed. For example, there's no need for diamonds. There's not much available. Gold also not much available. Other components, silver is used, lead is used. So that's excessively available. More important than that is crops. So that's more readily available. Then more important than that is water. So Allah has made that more available. And the most needy thing is oxygen. So Allah has made that freely available. Likewise, Hidayat is available. But for us to get this Hidayat, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has linked it to sacrifice. And Allah has linked it to certain conditions for us to benefit from this hidayah. So to benefit from Qur'an, we need to make a niyat of hidayah. شَهْرُ رَمَضَانَ الَّذِي أُنزِلَ فِيهِ الْقُرْآنِ هُدَلْ لِلنَّاسِ Hidayat. Likewise, وَنَزَّلْنَا عَلَيْكَ الْكِتَابِ تِبْيَانًا لِكُلِّ شَيْءٍ This Qur'an is a clarity, it's clear, it gives bayan, it describes everything in detail and what else? وَهُدَى وَرَحْمَةٌ It is a means of hidayat, mercy, وَبُشْرَى لِلْمُسْلِمِينَ And a guideline for the people of Iman. يَهْدِي بِهِ اللَّهِ مَنِ اتَّبْعَ رِضْوَانَهُ That whoever is seeking the pleasure of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah will guide them. قَدْ جَاءَكُمْ مِنَ اللَّهِ نُورٌ وَكِتَابٌ مُبِينٌ This kitab has come. It is a nur and a means of hidayat. What does it do? وَيُخْرِجُهُمْ مِنَ الظُّلُمَاتِ إِلَى النُّورِ It takes a person out of darkness and وَيَهْدِيهِمْ إِلَى صِرَاطٍ مُسْتَقِيمٍ And it is a means of hidayat, guidance to the straight path. يَا أَيُّهَا النَّاسِ كَدْ جَاءَكُمْ مَوْعِذًا مِنْ رَبِّكُمْ وَالشِّفَاءٍ It is a lesson. It is a shifa and huda, and it is a means of hidayat. وَلَكِنْ جَعَلْنَاهُ نُورًا نَهْدِي بِهِ مَنْ نَشَاءُ It is a nur that Allah gives whom He wants. So hidayat. So this Quran is compacted. It is a power-packed ingredient for hidayat. We know at that time where those forms of poetry were put on the Baytullah and it was there for a long time. But the Qur'an, forget it being hidayat, just the words of the Qur'an were means of hidayat. Just the balaghat and the eloquence of the Qur'an for people that did not have iman. A person, a Bedouin, heard somebody saying just this ayah, فَاسْدَعْ بِمَا تُؤْمَرْ فَسَجْدَ He fell into sajda. Why? Because of the eloquence of these few words. So it's very simple. We need to go to the ulama and see the balaghat and the eloquence of the Quran. Somebody heard this ayah, فَلَمَّا اسْتَيْأَسُوا مِنْهُ خَلَسُوا نَجِيًّا And he said that I accept Islam, I become a Muslim because this will not be the words of a human being. Utbah ibn Rabi'ah went to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam to propose the different options of the Quraysh. And when he finished, Nabi alayhi salam said that أَقَدْ فَرَغْتَ يَا أَبَا الْوَلِيدِ Did you finish what you needed to say? He said, نَعَمْ Then he said, فَاسْمَعَ مِنِّي Listen for what I have to say. You said what you needed to say. Now listen what I need to say. فَتَلَىٰ عَلَيْهِ آيَاتِ Then Nabi alayhi salam read some ayat from Surah Fussilat. And Utbah returned and he told his people, لَقَدْ جَاءَكُمْ أَبُو الْوَلِيدِ بِغَيْرِ الْوَجْهِ The people seen him and said he's come in an appearance, not in the form he left. And when he sat, مَا وَرَاءَكَ يَا أَبُو الْوَلِيدِ This what's wrong? Looking abnormal, he said, سَمِعْتُ قَوْلًا وَاللَّهِ مَا سَمِعْتُ مِثْلَهُ قَتُّ I've heard words, I've never heard something like that before. مَا هُوَ بِالشِّعْرِ وَلَا بِالسِّحْرِ It is not poetry, it is not sorcery. أَطِيعُونِي Listen properly and leave this person. فَوَاللَّهِ But thus were the words of Allah and he did not get hidayat. So, such powerful words, but Allah had not decided hidayat for him. So again we learn that what all the sharait and conditions, amongst them is dua as well. We need to draw hidayat and Suratul Fatiha is a dua and we need to be crying to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala But even they knew, the mushrikeen knew the power of the Qur'an, just the words of the Qur'an. وَقَالَ الَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا لَا تَسْمَعُوا لِهَذَا الْقُرْآنِ They told everybody, and these ayat were describing the condition of the kuffar, that they told everybody that do not listen to the Qur'an, do not come close to the Qur'an. If you listen to this Qur'an, then you'll also be guided. You will accept what Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said. According to them, you will be misguided, etc. But actually, you will be rightly guided. And they knew the effect and the power of the Qur'an. Hazrat Tufayl bin Amr al-Dawsi also, when he came to Mecca and the Quraysh, knew about his status. So they were worried that he will hear. So they encouraged him that he should put some cotton wool in his ears and not listen to what Nabi alayhi salam is saying. But when he heard what Nabi alayhi salatu salam said, then he read the Shahada. So people who were open enemies of Islam, people who were far away from deen, just the words of the Quran were so powerful that they were given the gift of Iman and Hidayah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala himself explains that this is the book of Hidayat and this is the power of the Quran. لَوْ أَنزَلْنَا هَذَا الْقُرْآنَ عَلَى جَبَلٍ This Quran was revealed on a mountain. لَرَأَيْتَهُ خَاشِيًا مُتَسَدِّعًا مِّنْ خَشَّةِ اللَّهِ You would have seen it falling down, splitting, shattering, turning to ash, turning to dust because of the fear of Allah. And Allah is saying, I'm giving you this example. لَعَلَّهُمْ يَتَفَكَّرُونَ So you need to ponder and you need to realize that if mountains were addressed, then the mountains would have understood the Quran. And the reality of the Quran was so powerful that it would have shaken and trembled. This was the mountain. Imagine insan who is made of flesh. When he hears the Quran, what's supposed to happen? So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala describes, تَقْشَعِرُ مِنْهُ جُلُودَ الَّذِينَ يَخْشَوْنَ رَبَّهُمْ That when they hear the Quran, they tremble, they fear. The ayat of the Quran are so powerful that their flesh and their hearts become soft. ثُمَّ تَلِينُ جُلُودُهُمْ وَقُلُوبُهُمْ إِلَىٰ ذِكْرِ اللَّهِ That their hearts become soft when they hear the ayat of the Quran. So, ذَلِكَ الْكِتَابِ لَا رَيْبَ فِيهِ In the beginning chapters, Suratul Fatiha, Dua for Hidayat. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is again telling us that Hidayat, Hidayat, Hidayat. For who? هُدَلْ لِلْمُتَّقِينَ So, this Qur'an is hidayat for the muttaqeen. A person can draw hidayat, but we need to know how to draw hidayat. And we need to ponder on the ma'ani of the Qur'an. Ibn Taymiyyah, you say, مَنْ تَدَبَّرَ الْقُرْآنَ طَالِبًا الْهُدَى Whoever ponders on the Qur'an, and he is desirous of hidayat, تَبَيَّنَ لَهُ تَرِيقُ الْحَقِّ That the road, the path through to truth will enter his heart. If Imam Shafi rahmatullah alayhi say that إِذَا أَرَدْتَ الصَّلَاحَ قَلْبِكَ If you intend hidayat for your heart, islah and reformation, or for your children, or for your brothers, أَوْ مَنْ شِئْتَ صَلَاحَهُ Whoever you want their reformation to take place, then I advise you fi riyadhil Qur'an that engage in the Qur'an, be in the company of the Qur'an wa bayna suhbatil Qur'an sayuslihu Allahu sha'am aba bi'idhni that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will guide this person here. So guidance, one of the conditions is taqwa. هُدَلْ لِلْمُتَّقِينَ For the muttaqeen. So, the Kalam-e-Pak is a means of hidayat, and when we start to recite the Quran, let us make a niyyah and an intention that we'll be reading this Quran for the intention of hidayat. The amal for today is that a person whose two children passes away, Nabi alayhi salam addressed the masturat and said, illa kanu laha hijaban minan nar, they will be protected from the fire. So if two children pass away and you are patient, you will be protected. Wa akhiru da'wana alhamdulillahi rabbil alamin.